recognized symbol of excellence in sports entertainment.
World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion, the Incredible Hulk Hogan!
Welcome, Gorilla Monsoon here at ringside with Bobby the Brain Heenan. Another tremendous lineup coming up this week, Bobby.
As always.
As always, it's true. We're going to take a look at the Junkyard Dog teaming up with George the Animal Steel.
I wonder who's going to be doing the thinking for that team.
Both of them will be doing a whole lot of thinking. Take a look at Jake the Snake Roberts.
Want to play that game again? Guess what's in the sack?
Definitely not, but you know the Dragon will be thinking about that. Billy Jack Haynes making an appearance here in the World Wrestling Federation.
I wonder if he'll be wearing his green and gold for Oregon.
Definitely will. Pedro Morales teaming up. Two former Intercontinental Champions
with
him
Tito
and Tito Santana.
Yes, the Tijuana Vice.
Tijuana Vice. One of your men, Handsome Harley Race, joining us this
week. That's right, the handsome one.
And, of course, another tremendous tag team match. Mike Rotundo and the Golden Boy, Danny Spivey. All that action. Let's go up to our ring announcer.
This is a tag team matchup scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, a tag team with both gentlemen hailing from Comac, Long Island, New York. First of all, weighing 233 pounds, Gino.
Open August 9th and 10th. It's coming to Nesson in August, where we deliver the best sports action in New England all summer long.
Three!
Yay!
You know, I always wanted the best of my kids. The best neighborhood, the best schools. But most important was my father's advice. Give of yourself. Dad would always find time to have a catch with us or take us to a ball game. I think that gave us a special family closeness.
Hey, Dad.
That's why I take my kids to baseball games. You owe it to them.
Major League Baseball, a family tradition.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my left from Romania, weighing 233 pounds, Johnny Canine. And his opponent, hailing from Portland, Oregon, at 246 pounds, Billy Jack Haynes.
Billy Jack Haynes invading the World Wrestling Federation. Gorilla Monsoon here at ringside with Bobby the Brain Heenan out of Portland, Oregon, a powerhouse, Bob.
You know, I thought maybe that was a big high top hat he had. That's his head. His head fits the whole hat. Amazing.
You would like to say that if Billy Jack was in earshot of you, Bob.
Are you kidding? If they can't take a little constructive criticism.
That's not constructive criticism. You're trying to humiliate the man.
Why should I bother doing that? He's going to do it anyway. Just stick around and watch.
You're going to see one fantastic athlete here in Billy Jack Haynes.
What does it say on the back of his trunk, sir?
Oregon. He's from Portland, Oregon.
Oh, that's nice. I mean,
golden green, the colors.
I don't have Beverly Hills written on my underwear.
You don't need it.
I don't have the names of where I come from.
You have any underwear. You probably don't even have any underwear.
I beg your pardon.
Master, I understand, Bobby, and I've seen him apply it of late here. The full Nelson. One of the most devastating ones since the days of the infamous Charles Atlas. Side headlock now by John Canine.
Wasn't Atlas the guy who used to get sand kicked in his face?
No, not that one. Oh. Hip lock, beautifully done. Oh, nice drop kick. Showing a lot of agility here. John Canine taking a hike for himself. Had a chance earlier on to have a few words with Billy Jack and stated he's here because he knows that right here is the greatest wrestling talent in the world, located in the World Wrestling Federation, and he wants the top action around.
Well, I will say this. Billy Jack Haynes has been very successful all over the world, and he's just going to have to prove himself to me. This is my first look at the guy, and he's strong, and he does put people away real quick with their full Nelson. But you have to do a little more to impress me than just have the name of where you're from on the back of your trunk.
Well, I don't know. I think if you don't, you obviously never went to college. You don't know what the glory stuff is all about. You ever go to college?
Yes, I did go to college.
Oh, okay.
Rob, sis, boom, bah. I'm not for all that.
Obviously. Reverse chin lock now by Billy Jack Haynes. Oh, excuse me. That'll get your attention. John Canine, one of the maybe proteges of Bobby the Brain Heenan, not faring too well this week.
Well, I didn't say he was going to become a protege of mine.
No, but you said it wasn't out of the question either.
Nothing's out of the question in the sport of professional wrestling. You know that. You might put the trunks on again and want me to manage you. You don't know.
Highly unlikely.
That I would manage you? Exactly.
Highly unlikely that I would put the trunks on again. Oh, beautiful knee lift by Billy Jack.
Do you have any of your old trunks?
No, I don't.
You got rid of everything?
Absolutely.
Were they repossessed or did you just get rid of them?
No, everything went into the Pacific Ocean when I retired.
You weren't in them right now,
No, I wasn't, no. Wow, I gouged his John Canine stuck the thumb right into the eye of Billy Jack. First bit of offense we've seen in this match from John Canine.
Get it out of the corner,
Canine. Forearm smash, referee telling him to get it out of the corner, but not listening.
Come on.
Uh-oh. He's saying, oh, Billy Jack said, come on, is that the best you can do?
Get it out of the corner.
Obviously it is, and now he's backing up. He obviously rose the ire of Billy Jack Haynes. Watch out. Backdrop. Whether he wanted to go or not, he had no choice. Maybe we'll see that patented Phil Nelson. Give you an idea of what it's like. Backbreaker coming up. Extremely well executed.
I will say Billy Jack is put together quite well.
He certainly is. On the second turnbuckle now, on the inside, look out. Oh, dropping a forearm right across the sternum. Makes John Canine wish he was look, he's sneaking up now. We're going to see it. There it is. Phil Nelson slapped on. Look at the hands high on the back of the head. That's where that tremendous pressure comes from. And John wasted no time in saying, ring the bell, please.
You know, that's very dangerous. Oh, you could break somebody's neck with that.
Let's get the official word.
The winner of this bout, Billy Jack Haynes.
Stay with us, an interview coming up.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you are looking at the top of the King of the Ring trophy. It will go to the winner of the second annual King of the Ring tournament right here at Sullivan Stadium in Foxborough, Monday night, July 14th. And remember, in addition to the King of the Ring tournament, the tag team title inside the steel cage, the British Bulldogs against the Dream Team. But that King of the Ring tournament last week, you saw the drawing take place. You heard the pairings. And Magnificent Morocco, I must admit, the one that surprised me the most.
I know. You form a lot of relationships in professional wrestling. A lot of them come and a lot of them go. And very seldom can you call a man your friend. Very seldom can you call a man your brother. Roddy Piper and I have traveled from coast to coast, from country to country. And the conspiracy has put us together, but...
Now wait, how can you call it a conspiracy? You saw the drawing.
But just like I stand here, without the spangles, without the sequence, just as Piper stands here in his kilt and represents what he represents, we don't need the glitter, we don't need the shine, you see, but when we get into the ring... When we get into the ring, I am King of the Ring, brother. I am King of the Ring. When we get into the ring, we set all our friendships aside. We set all the past behind us, and we concentrate right on the moment, right on the present, right on what is happening right now, and that is King of the Ring. Roddy Piper or Magnificent Morocco. And it's got to be one. And he's going to go for it. Just like I am.
Well, that one I guarantee you don't want to miss. Magnificent Morocco and Roddy Piper. Part of the King of the Ring tournament, Monday night, July 14th.
It's a super summer spectacular. The WWF at Sullivan Stadium in Foxborough. Monday, July 14th at 8 p.m. Tickets are on sale at all Ticketron locations in the area. You'll see the second annual King of the Ring tournament. Among those entered, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, the Junkyard Dog, the Magnificent Morocco, Rowdy Roddy Piper, and then the British Bulldogs defend the tag belts against Greg the Hammer Valentine and Brutus Beefcake, about to be held inside a steel cage. The super summer spectacular, June 14th, Sullivan Stadium.
No matter where you are, with thumb rustlers, it's just like being in a wrestling ring. with Hulk Hogan and Rowdy Roddy Piper.
One, two, three, kick!
Wherever you are, it's like real wrestling action. With Junkyard Dog and Bulldog. Come wrestle anywhere with Hulk and the Iron Sheik.
Okay, kids, back to class.
Wrestle anywhere with wrestling superstars, some wrestlers, new from LJN.
Now you can experience the battle of the monster trucks on video cassette. See Bigfoot, USA One, Monster Vet, and more in car-crushing drag races. See plenty cars, wheelie trucks, dragster tractors, and mud bog racing. Battle of the Monster Trucks is not available in video stores. Order today. Call 1-800-554-7000 to get your VHS or beta copy for just $29.95 plus $3 shipping and handling. Order now and get a Matchbox Monster Truck toy free. Use your Visa or MasterCard. Call now, 1-800-554-7000.
Welcome to Fishing the West, featuring the West's most impressive scenery, magnificent sport fish, and top guides and pros. From the Baja coast to Alaska, from the desert lakes of the great Southwest to the steelhead and salmon streams of the north, each week different pro guides and outstanding anglers reveal their secrets. We'll go after walleye, rainbow, sturgeon, eastern brook, Alaskan halibut, and king salmon.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first to my right, from Tocula, Mexico, weighing 244 pounds, Tito Santana. His partner from Culebra, Puerto Rico, at 240 pounds, Pedro Morales. Their opponent from Bulgaria, at 236 pounds, Don Kulov. His partner from Tampa, Florida, weighing 241 pounds, Terry Gibbs.
Well, tremendous tag team combination here in Tito Santana and Pedro Morales, two former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champions. What a tremendous duo they have today.
Where is Santana from?
Tocula, Mexico.
Where is Morales from?
Morales is from Culebra, Puerto Rico.
Both two big city boys.
Yes. Very impressive credentials, too. Terry Gibbs and Mr. Koloff forming the opposition. You can bet that the World Wrestling Federation and the fans all over the world will be talking about this combination. Incidentally, Bobby, the entire wrestling world buzzing about supposedly you putting Andre the Giant on the show. For my money, the jury is still out, Bobby.
Look, I'm going to tell you something one time only, Monsoon. Andre the Giant has been suspended from professional wrestling by Jack Tunney, the president of the World Wrestling Federation. If you have not seen the Giant, you will not see the Giant. He is finny. He is done. Highly unlikely. You see him around? They had a hearing. The man refused to wrestle a match.
Well, we've got some words of wisdom on tape here from Captain Louis Albano. Let's see what he says.
You're telling me about Andre the Giant being suspended and Bobby Heenan putting it up before the public. You're telling me about him not being there. Well, I want to tell you, I'm going to the highest court, always, always, my way, their way, to have him reinstated. I'm ready. People, I know you're behind me. Brothers and sisters, we're ready to have Andre back where he belongs. He's been nothing but a credit to you people, to myself, and to the rest of the world. I'll go to any expense. I'm ready. Be ready. You're ready.
Captain Lou, obviously extremely upset, and he said he's going to do everything and anything necessary, Bobby, to get Andre back.
Please, you don't see me upset. You see him upset. The reason he's upset is because he knows he lost Andre the Giant. The man's finished in professional wrestling. He talks he's going to go to the highest court. My attorneys are from Beverly Hills. His attorney works out of a cab at 47th and Broadway in New York City. So don't talk to me about the judicial system or attorneys. Andre the Giant never even made it to the hearing. Neither did Albano. They had no case. There was no case. Andre chickened out of a match with Studd and Bundy. He can go to the highest court. By the time he gets to the highest court, it could take 5-6 years. And if Andre was reinstated by that time, he'd be lost. He wouldn't know what to do at that time. He's on the shelf. He's done.
he right now is probably have a tour guide service in Grenoble, France.
He's done.
Look at this, figure four leg lock slapped on by Tito Santana, and Koloff wastes no time in calling it quits. Tremendous tag team combination here, Pedro Morales, Tito Santana.
Holy mackerel, let's get the official word.
The winners of this tag team matchup, the team of Pedro Morales and Tito Santana.
Tremendous victory here this week. Of course, Bobby the Brain Heenan claiming that Andre the Giant is gone forever. We will never see him again. Highly unlikely. I believe that Captain Louis Albano can pull some strings and do something. Look at this now. Double clothesline taking down Koloff in a hurry. And now Tito, wasting no time, really slaps this thing on. And Koloff wastes no time in saying, I give up. Tremendous tag team combination. As we stated earlier, we're going to be seeing a whole lot more of them in the weeks and months to come here in the World Wrestling Federation. And I think the jury is definitely not back yet on the Andre situation. Captain Louis Albano has been known to make waves in a whole lot of different ways. And Bobby the Brain Heenan will have to get up very early in the morning to slip anything by the illustrious Captain Lou. Right now, let's go to the body shop.
Here we have another beautiful, magnificent moment with the WWF and the celebrities of the WWF. When we're talking about Colossal, as the WWF is, we're talking about Behemoth. And I have with me the pleasure, Big John Studd and King Kong Bundy and their excellent manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. John Studd, of course, you know, is the giant, the new giant of professional wrestling. And King Kong Bundy, the people's world champion. Let me ask you this question first of all, John. How does it feel to now be the new giant of professional wrestling?
Well, you know, it feels absolutely wonderful, Mr. Morocco. It took a long time, but we were persistent. The Heenan family never gives up, and we chased Andre from one arena to the other, and we finally caught him and destroyed the legend of Andre the Giant. But look at our new champion.
Now, yeah, I haven't seen you since Phoenix, Arizona, and that's good seeing you again.
That's right, down.
How does it feel? How does it feel being the new People's World Champion?
Well, you know, Don, it's like you said, Bundamania is running wild. Hulkamania, you know, Hulk Hogan's got one foot in the grave, the other on a banana peel. And, you know, we got one more nail to put in that coffin, and we're going to do it.
And I'd like to say, Don, that Don Johnson doesn't have a thing on you, brother.
You're like a movie star.
Bundamania, I love it. I heard that blowhard Albano out here talking about his lawyers and everything else about Andre. He is gone, we know that.
The only lawyer he's ever had is a guy that was his public defender when he got busted for eating too much in some cheap diner. That's the only thing Lou Albano's ever done. He's a big mouth. I hate a person with a big mouth. But I'd like to compliment you on another great, magnificent moment of wrestling with you, Don.
Here it is. All the great stars of the world, the Colossus of the two behemoths of professional wrestling, Big John Studd, King Kong Bundy, Bobby the Brain Heenan, Magnus of Morocco, it's been your pleasure.
I used to be frightened by all the wine coolers I saw. I was scared I wouldn't pick the right one. Luckily, I did. It was the most refreshing one of them all, Sun Country Wine Cooler. You see, Sun Country is a blend of premium white wine and real fruit juice. That's what gives it its great taste. Sun Country, say, give me the real juice cooler. If you don't say Sun Country,
you'd better sleep with your lights on.
For every man who wears Brute deodorant, there's a woman who'll always be glad that he did. Because a man who wears Brute deodorant is nice to be close to. And nobody knows that better than a woman. Only Brute deodorant gives you long-lasting protection with the great smell of Brute.
Hello.
Brute, it smells like a man.
Most successful investors do their own investing, control their own financial affairs, and can utilize a discount firm like Schwab and Company very effectively. The great advantage, I think, in dealing with a Schwab employee who is salary-based and compensation is that you will always know that he does not have a conflict of interest writing on your transaction. Even more than the savings on commissions that we provide investors, we give them a haven where they can conduct their business without all of the hassles and the opinions and pressures from salespeople. I have always been an investor myself, and I have tried to think of everything that we do for our customers through the eyes of myself. Would I like it as a customer? Would I not like it as a customer?
Save money on brokerage commissions. Call Charles Schwab now for this free booklet. Toll free 800-762-3100. That's 800-762-3100. Find out what Charles Schwab can do for you.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing 245 pounds, Tony Garea. His opponent, from Kansas City, Missouri, at 254 pounds, Handsome Harley Race.
Gorilla Monsoon here at ringside with Bobby the Brain Heenan. What a lot of nerve, Handsome Harley Race. Give me a break, Bobby.
Give me a lot of nerve. That man's a very good-looking man.
Yeah, maybe to his mom, but that's about all.
I think he's handsome. I don't know a lot of people.
Tony Garea with a nice shoulder block off the ropes and another high cross body. Yell, sit down, job, one count. No, that's all he got. Tony Garea, named synonymous with professional wrestling. Five-time co-holder of the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. Very impressive credentials. Of course,
Harley Race. Did Garea have five different partners?
Five different partners, yes.
Couldn't find one to stay with him, could he?
Well, variety, the spice of life, buddy.
And a friend who needs a pest.
No, that's not true. Handsome Harley, of course, enters the World Wrestling Federation here with a really impressive ring record. Would you like to elaborate on that?
I don't think we have enough time.
Oh.
The man has a list of credentials probably bigger than Lou Albano's appetite.
Harley Race, very deliberate in the way he operates. Headbutt right to the forehead of Tony. Look at him. What is he about? Ziggy's a ballerina? Look at that. He wasted so much time, Garea was gone by the time he come down to the canvas.
He never wastes a second.
Well, he certainly telegraphed that move far enough in advance so that Garea could get out of the way.
Luck. Garea was lucky.
Obviously a southpaw. Is he a southpaw, Riley? To me, he's obviously one.
What, you think he's a northpaw?
Well,
he's a southpaw.
I'm asking.
You're
the manager. Supposed to know all these details about your men. Snap airs Garea over nicely.
Hey, being host of the show, I don't mind telling you. Yes, he is left-handed.
I understand that he's here in the World Wrestling Federation for one reason and one reason only, and that's the gold currently worn around the waist of one Hulk Hogan.
Well, that's the reason there are a lot of people in the World Wrestling Federation. They want the gold, but I think Harley Race is the man that's going to get it.
Watch out. Pile driver coming up. Yes. Right on the cranium of Garea, but those feet are over the bottom rope. They'll never be able to pin him that way. I believe he's already knocked Tony semi-conscious. Oh, look at those elbows. Imagine the impact of the blow coming down.
He's not ready yet. He's not ready to finish him off. Harley's having fun. He takes his time. He enjoys what he's doing in there.
I'll tell you what, you take every opportunity. Oh, nice reverse neck breaker. If you let a guy like Garea get by when you can beat him, it can turn around to haunt you. 1.5 count as Garea kicks out of there. Those cobwebs are starting to clear now from the pile driver. But Race, very methodical. Garea in for the ride. Catches him with a knee right in the back. Tony almost got out of the way of that one. He tried to.
Well, Garea's not that smart. He should have ducked under. That's what I would have done.
Well,
but Harvey'd have been there to catch him anyway.
I've seen you put the tights on too many times of late.
Like I said, I don't care to get my hands soiled. You come up with enough money, I'll put the trunks on.
Garea unloading with a couple of big right hands. And now he's got the handsome one backing up. Oh, headbutt planted right in the sternum area. Actually, a little lower abdomen there. Garea in for the ride again. Shoulder block sends Race down to the canvas. Oh, nice over the top by Tony and a double one. Oh, went for the high cross body. Didn't make it.
Using his brains. I told you, he can beat you physically. He can beat you wrestling. You want a street fight?
Look out.
Brains. Look at this.
cradle job into a suplex. This one is all over. One, two, three. Easy three count. Well, Harley Race, easy victory over Tony Garea. Stay with us. A special message from a superstar of the World Wrestling Federation.
You know, this one, my name is the Junkyard Dog. You know, it's summertime. It's very, very hot outside. And you know, everybody got that dog. I carry my dog up and down the road. But when you leave a dog inside of a car, leave a little crack in the window, because every dog needs air to breathe.
What's that?
One of those new Hostess pudding pies. Want some?
Maybe a little.
Plain pudding never tasted this good.
Mmm.
Chocolatey icing on top.
Uh-huh.
Great crust.
Wow.
And tons of creamy, real vanilla pudding inside.
What are you doing?
New Hostess pudding pies. Plain pudding just can't taste this good.
You ate the whole thing. Saved you some.
Now you too can get VIP treatment and big savings just by carrying the Players Club go-card.
You'll save money on rooms, on top-name entertainment, on food and beverages.
And you'll never have to wait in long registration and show lines again.
Look, you can stay at some of the finest resorts in the world's most exciting vacation cities.
Hey, no strings attached to get the club's benefits. You listen to telly? Call Players Club today.
This nerd is in for a blast, a frosty banana blast, a quick blast of fresh breath that can send your head to places everybody dreams of going.
Is this yours?
The Banaka Blast.
For every man who wears Brute deodorant, there's a woman who'll always be glad that he did. Because a man who wears Brute deodorant is nice to be close to. Brute, it smells like a man.
Great.
What would you like?
Well, I don't know. What do I feel like?
Why don't I try something you've never had before?
Is that a line?
No, it's a drink. Seagram's Golden Wine Cooler. It's wet, it's dry, it's new, and it's Seagram's.
You sound like a commercial.
You buying it?
The drink? Yeah, but not the line.
It's a start.
New Seagram's Golden Wine Cooler. It's wet and it's dry.
This tag team match is scheduled for one fall. In the ring at this time, from New York City, weighing 271 pounds, John Rizzo. His partner claims to be Canada's greatest athlete from Hamilton, Ontario, at 282 pounds, Iron Mike Sharp. Their opponent from Syracuse, New York, weighing 238 pounds, Mike Rotundo. His partner from Tampa, Florida, at 268 pounds, Golden Boy Danny Mighty.
All glory being taken around the ring by a very dynamic duo, Golden Boy Danny Spivey and Mike Rotundo. And you can bet both of these guys are born in the U.S. of A.
Boy, are we lucky, Monsoon. We just got to witness the world's shortest parade.
I'll tell you something. These two can put a dent in anybody. In fact, including, in my book, King Kong Bundy and Big John Studd.
Like you would say, Monsoon, give me a break.
Talk about excitement. Excitement personified. These two guys can deliver speed, strength, size. They have everything going for them. Mike Rotundo, All-American out of the University of Syracuse. Tremendous athletes. Iron Mike Sharp and Big John Rizzo supplying the opposition.
I figured it out. I know why they dress alike. It's not to impress the people. It's not because they're patriotic. It's so they won't get confused in the morning.
How would they be confused?
Well, this way, Bobby doesn't have to look for gold trunks or wonder where he misplaced them. If he misplaced them, he'll put on a pair of Rotundos. Everything kind of blends.
Nice block there by Rotundo against the right hand, the very dubious right hand of Iron Mike Sharp with that forearm support on it. Rotunda now in for the ride. Shoulder block, nicely done. Up quickly and down in front. Nice hip block. Oh, kick out immediately. Rotundo is quick. Oh, he just drove him down into the canvas. Elbow drop, but nobody there. Another one. Nope. Here comes a tag. And the big 6'8" golden boy, Danny Spivey, comes in off the second turnbuckle on the inside. These guys, you really can't appreciate about how big they really are until you get up close to them.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, Monsoon. I know that professional wrestlers today are bigger than they were 5 years ago.
No question about that.
Probably bigger than they were last week.
Oh, look at that. Nice one. All he had to do was raise a leg to get over there. Roll up coming up here. Can he get him? No. And Iron Mike chases in like a wild bull from the Pampas, but no one there. Runs right into a nice arm drag by the golden boy.
Why do you need the haircut? That's 1969 style. That's Haight Ashbury there.
That's 1986 style, I think.
No.
Nice reversal here by Spivey. Monkey flip coming up. Beauty. Just got him over.
You want to talk about style, you talk to me.
Yeah, like your guy with a bald head, right? And Rotundo coming in the hard way to the chagrin of Iron Mike. And right now, young John Rizzo has not been part of this match as yet. I think that Iron Mike might do well to make a tag here. He's not faring all that well himself, Bobby.
Sharp might surprise you. He might beat both these punks by himself. Rizzo can lock up the store if you want.
In a long part of town right now to be some double team effort. Come on, ref. Oh, look at that. Double cross as Rotundo ducks underneath that forearm shot.
Iron Mike might beat all three of them.
Including a referee, could make it four.
The one-man battle royal, isn't he?
Sometimes there's no rhyme or reason whatsoever to his balance of attack, if he has a balance of attack or a plan of attack. Rizzo almost got knocked down. He hasn't legally been in this match yet. Well, there's a little tag team combination work there. And now Rizzo has tagged in, I do believe. Yes. Side headlock. He is definitely close to that 350-pound mark. And Rotundo comes out from under there in a hurry. Now they're going to go to work on him. Look out. Make a wish. Talk about stretching out the hamstrings. That'll do it. The golden boy slapping on a step-over toe hold.
I think it would serve Rizzo well to stay away from Pizza Mania for a while.
Well, he certainly hasn't spent an awful lot of time in a gymnasium. He's developed some tremendous obliques, however.
On the same side.
Well-executed move. Hook of the leg by Rotundo. And Sharp over there to grab a handful of hair and save his partner. But I believe it's only temporary.
Well, Mike's everywhere, isn't he?
Another beautiful dropkick by Rotundo. The tag already made. So the golden boy is in there in a hurry. Look out, Bulldog coming up. Oh, yes. Face first, throw him down into the canvas. Good night.
Wave the stars and stripes.
Born in the USA is the theme song of that dynamic duo right there. Let's get the official word.
Your winners, the team of Golden Boy Danny Spivey and Mike Rotundo.
Well, I think Iron Mike Sharp should have stayed in there just a little bit longer, Bobby, because as soon as Big John came in, he was made quick work of. Let's go back and take a look at the Bulldog by the Golden Boy, Danny Spivey. Imagine the impact, 285 pounds, ramming you face first down into the canvas.
Sullivan Stadium, Foxborough, Monday night, July 14th. Get ready, fans. What an incredible night. It's going to be second annual King of the Ring tournament. And listen to these first round pairings. Of course, Mike Rotundo and Hercules Hernandez lucky enough to come away with the first round byes. Then Pedro Morales against Ace Cowboy Bob Orton. Golden Boy Danny Spivey against Nikolai Volkoff. JYD Junkyard Dog against Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. Billy Jack Haynes against the Iron Sheik. George the Animal Steel against Handsome Harley Race. And listen to this one. Magnificent Morocco against none other than Rowdy Roddy Piper. And if that's not enough, Monday, July 14th, inside of this 15-foot-high steel cage. At the request of Luscious Johnny Valiant, Jack Tunney, WWF President, agreed to it. Tag Team Championship is on the line. Johnny Valiant, inside of this 15-foot-high steel cage, your dream team against a British Bulldog.
You ever served time anywhere?
No, I haven't.
Have you ever served time?
No, I haven't.
No, I haven't, but I'm going to tell you something. I know people that have served time. And you know what they tell me about serving time? When you hear that click, when you hear that click, when you're inside of a cage or a prison, that's the most devastating noise you ever heard in your life. And in professional wrestling, this is the ultimate, pal. It doesn't get no rougher than a steel cage match. 15-foot-high steel cage match. In other words, when your head is ramming off a cyclone fence, you can feel it, baby. You can feel the devil bite your eye. That's the way it is.
You know, it's a dream come true for the Dream Team. And it's a Bulldog's nightmare because they went out there hastily and readily signed right there on the dotted line for a World Tag Team match, but they didn't see in the fine print that Luscious Johnny Valiant, the greatest manager of professional wrestling today in the WWF, happened to put down their steel cage. 15-foot-high steel cage right here in Foxborough in the Sullivan Stadium. I can't wait because I am a master in a steel cage, and the beeper, he knows what's happening. And he's going to tell you what's going to happen to the Bulldogs when they go through these 2-inch squares. That's the only way they're going through this cage.
You know, the Bulldogs, they get out here and they say, it's like two wild animals stepping against two wild animals. Well, they're almost right, you know, two Bulldogs against the Dream Team. But, you know, when it comes down to the steel cage and hurting you Bulldogs, that's what it's all about, man. That's why we got the cage. It's not for the belt, you understand? It's just because we want to put you out forever. Yeah. Because, you know, it's not going to be a pretty sight, man. Your head's going to go right through this cage, just like the cabinet.
Each day, an awful lot of paper lands on your desk. So should the Wall Street Journal. After all, information is in power. Knowing where to find it is.
Call 800-336-1111 for this special introductory offer. 13 weeks for just $29.50 with a money-back guarantee. 13 weeks, $29.50. Phone 800-336-1111 now for the Wall Street Journal.
The world of lacrosse meets on common ground once every 4 years. And on July 24th and 25th, Nesson will take you to Toronto, Ontario for the games of World Lacrosse 86. Teams from Great Britain, Australia, Canada, and the United States will feature the finest players in the game today in an unparalleled display of skill and speed. Check out World Lacrosse 86, July 24th, live at 8 p.m., followed by the championship game Saturday the 26th at 7:30, right here on Nesson. Don't miss it.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Diet 7 Up Clear and Bright.
This nerd is in for a blast, a frosty, refreshing Banaka blast, the blast you lose your head over.
Is this yours?
The Banaka blast.
Clubmen, fine toiletries and grooming aids for men. If you have only two vices, let one be Clubmen.
It's plumbing.
For hair clogs at their worst.
Oh, it's for you.
Liquid Plumber is the plumber to call first.
Well, wrestling fans, that wraps up another week here in the World Wrestling Federation. We saw some tremendous action, but Bobby, next week we're going to look at 5 tag team matches.
Boy, it's really going to be something, isn't it? And my team's going to be there.
Your team's going to be there, of course, King Kong Bundy and Big John Studd tag team action, and also Corporal Kirshner and King Tonga.
I don't want to talk about Tonga.
Obviously you don't. Adorable One, Adrian Adonis will be with us, and the fantastic Rougeau, Jacques and Raymond.
I wonder who will have the name on his back this week.
Well, we'll have to wait and see. And, of course, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the British Bulldogs.
I wish they were wrestling Studd and Bundy. You'd see new champions.
Highly unlikely that that would appear, but that will be a non-title match. And the Hart Foundation is going to join us as well. Until next week, Gorilla Monsoon for the Brain, saying so long.
And new World Wrestling